بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليك سيدي يا رسول الله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وقائدنا رسول الله محمد صلى الله وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي البهي وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين والقائل صلى الله عليه وسلم كل أمتي يدخلون الجنة إلا من أبى قيل ومن يأبى يا رسول الله قال من أطاعني دخل الجنة ومن عصاني فقد أبى فاللهم صل وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي البهي وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ثم أما بعد حياكم الله تبارك وتعالى وبياكم وأبقاكم عوامل رفع لهذه الأمة وحياكم وإذا كان أهلا ومرحبا إكثارها ترف وإسراف فألف أهلا ومرحبا فيكم ليست بإسرافي أسأل الله أن يبارك في جمعنا هذا ويجعلنا ممن يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه إنه ولي ذلك والقادر عليه All praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the sustainer, the creator, the cherisher and the provider We bear witness that there is no God but Allah and we bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. We are sending our blessings and our salutations to our beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our beloved Prophet Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are sending our blessings and our salutations also to the entire house of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we are sending our blessings and our salutations to the companions of Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our worship and our fasting. Allahumma ameen. Dear respected brothers and sisters, first of all, I start my speech by saying Ramadan Mubarak for everyone. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this Ramadan the best Ramadan that we have. Because when it comes to that concept that Allah blessed all of us by witnessing Ramadan. You are so blessed. And Allah blessed me and blessed all of you by allowing everyone to witness Ramadan. And do you remember this dua that we used to have in Rajab and in Sha'ban? That we used to say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Oh Allah, Allahumma balighna Ramadan. Oh Allah, let us reach Ramadan. And of course, Ramadan is here. Of course, Ramadan in action. And of course, alhamdulillah, Allah allowed all of us to witness Ramadan. How many people died in the last period? And Allah didn't choose us amongst them. So Allah gave us another chance to come to Ramadan and to witness Ramadan. So I need you now, please, to say Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah for this ni'mah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed us to reach Ramadan. Allah answered our dua. You are so lucky that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered your dua and gave you another chance to witness Ramadan. You remember this dua. Allahumma balighna Ramadan. Oh Allah, let us reach Ramadan. And let me tell you, Ramadan is here. Ramadan is action. And the race is on. The race started already. And by having the first day of Ramadan, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we need to be thankful to him that he allowed us to witness Ramadan. Lots of people have planned in the past to attend Ramadan, but Allah has another plan. Lots of people, we gathered together last year, but they are not with us this year in Ramadan. Lots of people, we used to see them, but that didn't happen this year. So it is another plan. And we are the ummah of accepting the destiny of Allah. And it is a sign of Iman that you accept the destiny of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to talk about the virtues of Ramadan, the blessings of Ramadan, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exactly wanted to see from us in Ramadan, and before going into more deep into the details of Ramadan and the virtues and the hadith of Ramadan, let me remind you of this verse that we are reciting almost every season and every day in Ramadan, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّوَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامِ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. All you who believe, fasting has been prescribed upon you as it was prescribed upon those who before you, so you may achieve taqwa. So remember, your target, your goal is to reach to that level of taqwa. But let me tell you the hadith to appreciate that you already witnessed Ramadan. And it is my gift to everyone at the first day of Ramadan. That hadith is narrated by Ibn Majah and by Tabarani, one of the great Sahaba, Sayyiduna Talha. Sayyiduna Talha narrated one day that he had two men, two brothers in al-Madina. One of them was doing his effort in ibadah, and he was doing better than his brother. Two brothers, one is good and the other is the best. The other is doing more and more, and he is striving and he exerting the effort to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the other one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose him to be in the battlefield, and he had been killed as a martyr. So he had been killed as a shaheed. So what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made, and then the other one, the other brother, after one year passed away. So you have two brothers. One had been killed in the battlefield as a shaheed, and after 1 year, his brother passed away too. And Sayyiduna Talha is narrating this hadith, and he said, and I saw in the dream that we are standing before the gates of Jannah, the gates of paradise. And there is one of the angels came out, and he started to look at all of us, all the three of us. And he called the one who died 1 year after his brother, after the shaheed. And he called him and he said, come on and enter Jannah first. Then he called the shaheed and he came back to Talha and he said, it's not your time yet. You didn't get the permission yet. Wait, not now. Hold on. And Sayyiduna Talha woke up and he started to narrate this dream for everyone. And people wondered till the news came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he said, why you are wondering? Why you feel that something strange? They said, Ya Rasulallah, because the one who died 1 year later, he entered Jannah before the shaheed. He said, Alaysa qad shahida Ramadan? Isn't he witnessed one more Ramadan than his brother? And this is what made him in that position and in that situation. This is the reality. This is the case. You witnessed another Ramadan. And that man who entered Jannah before the shaheed, because he witnessed Ramadan, Rasulullah ﷺ said again, أَلَيْسَ قَدْ شَهِدَ رَمَضَانِ. Isn't he witnessed extra Ramadan, one more Ramadan? How many sajda he made? How many rak'ahs he made? So this is the race, and this is the marathon of Ramadan. It is the competition of Ramadan. So race is on, and race is here. And before we go again to the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, let me tell you something And I need you to imagine this right now. I need you to imagine what I'm telling you. Maybe it will not happen on the reality, but it just imagine it, you know? Just imagine it. I need you to share this time with me in just imagining this scenario. Imagine that a certain bank, let's say one of the major banks in the all over the world, that decided that you are one of the winners, so they chose you to take the money, and they brought you to the treasure, and they opened the doors, which has like wheels, you know, and they gave you time, and they told you, here you have 2 hours, just 2 hours. Take whatever you want, as much as you can, it's yours, from the money, from the treasures, from the gold, silver, diamond, everything. And they closed the door, and they said to you, here's the time. And you have a timer, and the count started to come down, and you have 2 hours to take whatever you want. So can you imagine now? Just put yourself in this situation. 2 hours, they opened the gates of the treasures, and 2 hours, it is limited to take whatever you want. So how you will react? Let me tell you something. We need to be honest when we answer such questions. How you will react? Will you be able to be busy with anything? Do you have time for a friend or to pick up call? Do you have time for Facebook, for Twitter, for Instagram, for all this stuff? Do you have time for that? If they told you just 2 hours and you will take whatever you want, if your friend started to call you, will you respond? Will you pick up the call? This is the reality. No. Even if your wife called you, you may not respond. 2 hours and you will be the billionaire and you will be the richest person on earth. This is the case. So what about in this race, in this competition, in this marathon? Allah is telling you that now all the gates of Jannah are open and all the doors of the hellfire are shut down. And not only this, the leaders of the devils are chained up. So this is the case. Will you miss that, or you will exert the effort? I need you to make the most of this Ramadan by coming back to Allah and by exerting the effort. And this is the real challenge. As I told you, Allah is challenging our sincerity when it comes to the ibadah. You used to come to the masjid, standing behind the imam, standing maybe 1.5 hours, you know, what you are willing to do right now. Will you come? Will you come to Allah? Will you pray Taraweeh individually? It is the real test that we ever saw for the sincerity. Wallahi, many years I'm giving khutbas and lectures, more than 22 years till now. And it is the first time in my life I feel the sincerity. I feel the topic of sincerity like this situation. It is the race and it is the time. And let me tell you the virtues of Ramadan. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said 3 ahadith. Just, you know, when you have these 3 ahadith, I think it is more than enough to let you work and start, you know, exerting the effort in Ramadan. And all of them in al-Bukhari. So it is authentic hadith, highly authentic hadith. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Man saama Ramadan, whoever fasts in Ramadan out of iman, out of seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will forgive all his previous sins. And this is number one. Number two, whoever stands at night for the sake of Allah, out of iman, because of his sincerity, because he's seeking the pleasure and the reward of Allah, all his previous sins will be forgiven. Look at this. Look at this. Look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us about. He's offering Jannah. Allah is offering Jannah. And Don't listen to the shaitan. Don't be fooled with the shaitan when the shaitan tells you, what about, you know, leaving ibadah and being lazy all the year and you want to come to Jannah just in Ramadan? Yes. Don't listen to shaitan and say, okay, so Allah will not accept me. No, Allah will accept you. Allah will let you come back. Ramadan is the month that you can come from zero to hero, that you can come from nothing to reach to Jannah, from zero to hero. This is the case. Allah is offering Jannah. It's beyond our imagination. The reward in Ramadan, no one can miss that. It does not make any sense for any Muslim to lose Ramadan and to lose the virtues of Ramadan. And let me tell you the hadith. The third hadith that Rasulullah mentioned in al-Bukhari, that each and every Muslim fasting for the sake of Allah, Allah gave him every day in Ramadan one da'wah that Allah will answer, one du'a, and the time for du'a to be answered, the time that he will come to have iftar. So while before you are doing your iftar, I need you to spend this time in making lots of du'a to the one that you love, to all the brothers and sisters, to Allah, to take this calamity away and to release it. And let us return back to our masajid and let the people of Umrah and the Hajj go back to al-Masjid al-Haram and al-Masjid al-Nabawi. And this is what we need. I need you to invest this time. Make the most of this Ramadan and show Allah that Allah, oh Allah, I had something good in my intention. Give your best when it comes to the worship. Give your best when it comes to the dhikr of Allah. Give your best when it comes to reciting Quran. Ramadan is the month of Quran. Ramadan is the month of ibadah. Ramadan is the month that you can remember Allah a lot, that you can stand before Allah, that you can stand in salah, telling Allah, oh Allah, even if I feel pain in my leg, I stand for your sake. I used to stand to play. I used to stand to waste my time. I used to stand to disobey you. But this is the time that I need to stand for your sake just to please you, oh Allah. This is what we need. Ramadan is the month that we need to recharge our batteries. Give your best. And my message to everyone, we have lots of people just today is preparing lots of food, massive amount of food, and they didn't realize that Ramadan is not the month of eating. Ramadan is the month of feeding. This is what we need, wallahi, to do. I need you to check on lots of orphans, lots of poor and needy. They want you. They need your contribution. If you even give them a plate, if you even give them something for the sake of Allah, Ramadan again. And remember this, Ramadan is not the month of eating. Ramadan is the month of feeding. Feed the poor and needy as much as you can with having the precautions steps. But do something and try to let everyone happy with this month. Jazakumullahu khaira. Just for the sake of the time, I wanted you to make lots of du'as, insha'Allah, and I will make the du'a now, insha'Allah, then I will get your questions if there is any, but let me remind you what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ. Hasten and rush to get the forgiveness of Allah and to get the Jannah. Allah is giving you the command to rush, to hasten, to compete each others. This is Ramadan, and this is the marathon of Ramadan. The marathon of Ramadan already started. Ramadan now in action. Show Allah that you have something good in your heart. Let's make the dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our worship. And let's make the dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those people who passed away, to be enveloped with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's make the dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to envelop everyone with his mercy. And let's make the dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, particularly at the beginning of Ramadan, at the first day of Ramadan. Let's make the dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cure those people who are sick in the hospitals and who are suffering in the hospitals. Let's make the dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send shifa to them and to give them his mercy in the hospitals, so they will get the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And let me just, before we start the dua, let me mention our mom and our sister Afsari, the wife of Dr. Rahim. Let's make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for her. She is sick in the hospital after like 4 or 5 surgeries, and still she needs your dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give her shifa. Allahumma ameen. Let's make dua also to brother Abdul Basit's cousin. His cousin passed away in Bangladesh today, and his name is Harun al-Rashid, Hajj Harun al-Rashid. So let's make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for him to forgive his sins and to be showered with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's make dua for everyone. This is the time of dua. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our du'as. Allahumma ameen. Allahumma laka alhamdu ya Rabbana kama tuhibbu wa kama tarda. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Allahumma taqabbal siyamana wa salatana wa ruku'ana wa sujudana. Allahumma shfi mardana wa mardal muslimin. Allahumma shfi ukhtana afsari ya rabbal alameen. Allahumma arham mawtana wa mawtal muslimin. Allahumma shfi kulla mariid. Allahumma afi kulla mubtala. Allahumma rufع عنا الوباء وارفع عنا البلاء. Allahumma ردنا إلى المساجد ردا جميلا. Allahumma ردنا إلى بيوتك ردا جميلا. Allahumma اغفر لنا ذنوبنا. اللهم أعنا على الصيام وأعنا على القيام. اللهم أعنا على قراءة القرآن. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا. اللهم ارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا. رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. اللهم تول أمرنا وأحسن خلاصنا وفك أسرنا وتوفنا وأنت راض عنا يا كريم. Oh Allah, we ask you to forgive our sins, the minor sins and the major sins. Oh Allah, we ask you to give us the ability to worship you and to fast in Ramadan and to come close to you, Ya Rabbi Al-Alamin. Oh Allah, we ask you to envelop everyone with your mercy. Oh Allah, we ask you to forgive our sins and to grant all of us the sincerity in our hearts in Ramadan, Ya Rabbi Al-Alamin. Oh Allah, we ask you to purify our intentions. Oh Allah, we ask you to grant all of us the intercession of Rasulullah Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and let us all come together under the shade of the throne, Ya Rabb al-Alameen, under the shade of your throne, Ya Rabb al-Alameen, and be in Jannat al-Firdaus with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jazakumullahu khayra. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And inshallah, I'm getting your questions. But before that, let me tell you, inshallah, as our schedule, we will have 15 minutes before iftar. We will come back, all of us as one community, to share the 6-7 minutes of tafsir, then dua for the sake of Allah, and we will have adhan at the same time. One of the youth group, inshallah, will share the adhan with us, so we can listen to the adhan together, and we will have iftar at the same time together, inshallah. Please don't miss it. 15 minutes before iftar, inshallah. Jazakumullahu khairan. And please, as I mentioned yesterday, don't feel, you know, hesitate to contact me at any time. If you have any question in your mind about salah, about zakah, about siyam, just call me and you will find me respond, inshallah. Jazakumullahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.